Good morning, church.
Good morning.
I am very happy to be here.
Amen.
And I mean it because this is my first time standing up here. And I'm really excited. It's good to be in the house of the Lord, isn't it? I come today for a special assignment. Most of you or everyone knows that in the last few months we have been working on transitions of some of our pastors. And this is what I usually share with church boards when we meet to talk about transition, because some of them, sometimes they will say, why? We love our pastor, why does he have to go? And I'll say this, that as a conference, I believe the understanding is that you have charged us to manage the resources of the Lord. And so what we do is sometimes we will listen to church members when they visit with us and say that we believe the marriage has been good, but maybe a little change will help. And we will listen, given the circumstances and the challenges. And if the pastor has been there for some time, couple years, we will listen to the board, do the best we can to make a transition happen. Sometimes it will be that the pastor may request, approach us and say that I want new challenges, and if you would be kind to consider me, I'll appreciate it, and we will take that into advisement as well. And then sometimes we may have a need, given that a church may be needing special skill sets, the challenges that they are facing. We believe that a pastor may be able to be the one with the resources and the experience to help us in that area. And in that case, we may tap into in the pastor and say, hey, elder, can you help us out here? And so these are the three main ways in which transition would take place. And so we've been working with the previous pastor as well as the church board to make this happen. And so pastors come and go. And as we know, sometimes it leaves us with sadness, because over time we bond together, we become a family, we share, we love each other, and then things happen that the pastor may have to move on. I can understand, I've been in situations like that, and today we come opening a new chapter in this church. And before I go to the litany that you have in your hands, I'd like to share a few Bible passages that help in this exercise. As you well know, pastors cannot lead churches alone. They need the support of the church members. And we find images in the scripture. One of them is found in the book of Exodus, chapter 17, and I pick up from verse 8. There was a dispute, if you will, between the Israelites and the Amalekites. And this is where we see a display of togetherness, resourcing, delegating, holding hands together, working together for a success. And so the Bible says the Amalekites came and attacked the Israelites at Rephidim. Moses said to Joshua, choose some of our men and go out to fight the Amalekites. That's the first delegation that you see. Moses realizes that I can't be everywhere, and so he delegates. And then he says, as I continue, tomorrow I will stand up on the hill with the staff of God in my hands. So Joshua fought the Amalekites as Moses had ordered, and Moses, Aaron, and Hur went to the top of the hill. As long as Moses held up his hands, the Israelites were winning. But whenever he lowered his hands, the Amalekites were winning. When Moses' hands grew tired, which every person will grow tired. And so Moses was tired and he couldn't hold his hand. Can you imagine that the people of God fighting and the man of God standing in front there holding his hands all day? It's impossible. So this is where another help, a support, comes in. So the Bible says that, when Moses hands grew tired, they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat on. Aaron on her, and Hur held his hand up, one on the side and one on the other, so that his hands remained steady till sunset. So Joshua overcame Amalekite army with this sword. We see in this passage a collaboration, a delegation, support, holding hands together and working together. And that is something that I imagine that in any church, for us to be successful, for us to lead in advancing the kingdom of God, we will hold hands together. And so as our new pastor, Pastor Kenroy Markholm, comes in, I do believe that we are going to see this kind of approach taking place in this church. But not only there, you go to chapter 24, you see similar thing happen there. God had called Moses to come up again to the mountain and stay there. And he says, I will give you, remember, God had given Moses the Ten Commandments, and he came and he was frustrated and he smashed them. And then God caused him to come back to the mountain again. So this is what happens. So chapter 24, I pick up from verse 12. It says, the Lord said to Moses, come up to me on the mountain and stay here. I will give you the tablets of stone with the law and commandments I have written for their instructions. Then Moses set out with Joshua, his aide, and Moses went up on the mountain of God. And listen to this, verse 14. He said to the elders, wait here for us until we come back. Aaron and Hur are with you, and anyone involved in dispute can go to them. Isn't that beautiful? Again, you see delegation, collaboration, support. Each one has a task to perform. And I pray that this will be the image that we will work with as we work with our new pastor. And now I invite my colleague and friend, Elder Markholm, to stand by me here. And as you see in the litany, there's a section for me. Unfortunately, Yvonne could not be here. His wife couldn't be here today, but I'm sure you will see her in later Sabbaths. And then there's a section for the congregation. There's a section also for Pastor Markholm. And so we will read accordingly. We come on this day to open a new chapter in the history of our church, the beginning of a new pastorate.
I come seeking to serve you in lifting up Jesus Christ, that together we may grow.
We invite you to lead us in our hour.
I seek your love as we become part of this church family.
We wish to have you as part of our family and we open our hearts to you.
God has given to you the challenge of leading these people in the preparation for the soon coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
I accept this challenge. Under God, we pledge to do our best to lift them up.
As a church, you face the challenge of presenting the gospel to your community. And all together, we covenant before Christ and each other this day to place Christ first, to seek the guidance of His Spirit, and to work together for the hastening of His coming. Amen. Before we pray together, I'd like to say a few things about Elder Markholm, and I'm sure he will share a lot more with you. Pastor Markholm has been in ministry over 3 decades. Started in Jamaica after completing his first theological training, worked. He has a wonderful story that he tells about how his mother dedicated him for the Lord's work. And I'm sure I will let him tell that part of the story. But after that, he came to further his education at Andrews Seventh-day Adventist Theological Seminary at Andrews University, where we met. Our path crossed because I went to West Indies College, but he had graduated. And then we met at Andrews University. Sometimes we played soccer together. And then after that, he went to Atlanta, Georgia for some time, and God, in his miraculous ways, we met again when the Southern England Conference extended a call, an invitation for the Malcolm to come and pastor the Pleasant Street Church. And I had just been an associate pastor to Pleasant Street and Northborough just before he came. And so again, we became friends, ministered in the same city. And then from there on, the conference asked Elder Malcolm to help and pastor Boston Temple Church. And then from Boston Temple, he also served at Lincoln and Brockton Seventh-day Adventist churches in both Rhode Island and Massachusetts. And then recently, we extended a call to him to come and pastor the Village Church here at South Lancaster. And today, we are adding another assignment to his work, the Sterling Church. And I'm very excited to be here today to present Pastor Malcolm. As I said, not only are we colleagues in ministry, we are friends. Sometimes I say this, he was my tennis partner. We played tennis together until he found love with golf. And he deserted me with my tennis thing. But I pray that God will be with Elder Malcolm. He's a man of God. He has one wife. He has two beautiful daughters. And I believe that in time you see his family. And so, Elder, I know if you want to give a response, just a brief words before you preach, then we pray together.
Thank you, Dr. Ma. I want to greet you with Jesus' joy and for the opportunity to serve you. I must say that I am grateful to serve after a great pastor you've had, Pastor Sierra. Rob has been a very good friend of mine, and we work together at the front gate at camp meeting. And there are many of you I have seen as I've been at locating, and so it's a joy to serve. I also wanted to say that my wife, Ivani is not here today, but my wife works at the Fitchburg State University. My wife is a CPA, she's an accountant. My daughter, Kenesha, is also a CPA. Both graduated from SLA, and both went to Oakwood, and she's a CPA now. Thank God for Christian education. And my first daughter, Jessica, also went to Oakwood and, you know, got a full scholarship to the University of Connecticut Medical School. And she's on her final year of residency at Yale Medical Center, and I praise God for what God has done for my children. And so I look forward to serving you. I've always had two churches. And so I said to the village that the honeymoon is over. I've always had two churches and served multi-church pastorates, and so I'm very comfortable with it, because in the island of Jamaica where I'm from, I have served as much as 14 churches. And so it's a difference. And so we praise God for what God has done, and I look forward in serving you, and that God will just bless us as we work together to see souls born for his kingdom, and as we continue to prepare ourselves for his coming.
Amen. Thank you, Elder.
want to thank Pastor Moore for welcoming our pastor, and I know he has to head to Worcester right now, so you'll excuse my pastor, and we'll see you at other times. I want to take this opportunity to welcome all of you here today. You know, it's an amazing thing when you come into an environment and you know that the people in the environment are happy to see you and you are welcome. I know the visitors are here today. Some of you are here for the very first time. I want to let you know you are welcome to this church, and I hope that this is not the first time, but you will keep coming. It's a place where we want to emphasize the name of Jesus, and you're always welcome to come. Also, regular members, we are glad to see you, and we pray that God will energize you to work for him and to use the gifts that he has given you. A church that uses its talents and gifts is like a person who exercises and develops good muscles. So all of you, I'm inviting you to ask yourself, Lord, what can I do for you? What can I do for this church? Where can I fit in? And if you're not sure, we can help you to find a spot where you can do something for the Lord. I'm going to make a few announcements very quickly, and then Fauna will make some announcements. My daughter was told me that our school, SLA, they're planning a dinner Friday evening, and the dinner is in support of the senior class. You know, every year the senior class, they have a mission, and they raise money for that particular mission, and it's a spaghetti dinner that is going to be at a college church from, I think, 6 to 7, and they have tickets available for this dinner, so if you're interested in supporting the senior class, make certain at the end of the church today you see me or Paula, and we can give you the tickets, and you can make arrangement on how to pay that ticket. I think it's $10 per ticket, but it's an opportunity for the class to get some funds to help them with their project for next year. Fawn?
Ah.
This Friday.
The 8th, yes. So.
Oh, okay. So that's the following week.
Yes, so you go ahead. Go ahead and mention what you were saying.
But anyway, we've been practicing for that, and there's a bunch of students at there.
That's tonight. Is it tonight?
No, that's the Friday night of alumni weekend.
Oh, yes. Okay, that's the 8th. Okay.
So just letting you folks know, it's going to be really nice.
Okay, so after the dinner, we'll have that, yes.
It's at 7 because I think they're having a dinner that night.
Yes, so after the dinner, we go right into that musical.
Yes.
Thank you. So, Fawn, you have a few announcements. Just go ahead and share. Okay.
I just have a couple. You know, when Paul played that, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, it reminded me, you know, Evan wanted to see Sandy Patty, and we went up to Portland, and of course my cousin Brian was there, and if you know my cousin, he's as shy as can get, and if you know Evan, he's on the front row, and so if you know Sandy Patty, she belted out like you've never heard a woman sing before, and so we're sitting there, and she's singing in a red dress, and I remember when she, you know, I mean, she can hit these notes that are higher than the piano, and people ask her, she said, people ask me how I can hit those high notes, and she said, I just was a good screamer. But blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Are you here in the name of the Lord today? I was reading John 12 this morning. Jesus had just raised Lazarus. And you know what? The priest's story that often. But this voice comes out of heaven. And they said, the crowd said it sounded like the angels. And it said, my name is being glorified. And I will glorify it again. You know, I was thinking about that. You know, God's going to glorify his name in you and in me again. And that song just brought all that to my memory. But today, Moses, Moses and I are your Pathfinder directors.
Amen.
And we had a wonderful campery. Thank you, everybody. It was just well put together. It was a great time there at SNEC. And I'd sure appreciate, again, the bigger leadership in our church and how much work goes into the kids. But today, we're going to teach the Dune Honor at Plum Island for the kids. And we've had the Mountains Honor. We're climbing Mount Wachusett. And we are trying to keep things outside and trying to keep your lungs healthy. So if you want to go, just see us after church. And I want to remind you folks, too, of the Uganda book. Pathfinders has taken on, you know, every month we're supposed to have an outreach. So our outreach is going to help the Gibbons, Paul and Margaret and Paula, collect 5,000 Christian books or wholesome books before December 1. So I have a little box out there. We filled boxes every week. Paul's taking these boxes as we fill them and putting them in his garage, right? Am I correct? So Margaret told me they're looking for 5,000 books. So
just 700 already.
Oh, good. So we're getting there. So go through your books at home and bring them if you don't want them. So next Sabbath, I promised you guys a farm Sabbath. And I know this, I hadn't put this together till this morning. If you know my brothers and I, we kind of are very spontaneous. But next Sabbath, after church, you all are welcome to go up to our farm in Vermont. And, you know, people pay thousands and thousands of dollars. It's a multi-billion industry to come to New England for the foliage. So I'm hoping that usually the second, third week in October, and we're getting there, is the high peak foliage week. So you're all welcome to come. But I need to know, because we're going to have hot dogs and s'mores, and we'll probably, my brothers are going to put some hay on the wagons, and we'll take you around the farm and maybe think of, you know, if you're Pathfinders, I'll have to throw in an honor there too. But we'll have hot dogs and s'mores down by the river. So let me know if you're in. And women's ministries, we have October 14. I have a sign-up sheet right here. We're going to be decorating here at the church from like 6 to 7. It doesn't take long at all. This craft is, you just plop some succulents on top and glue some leaves around the bottom. So if you have some glue guns, please let me know if I can borrow them, or we can, you know, use them that night or bring yours that night. But I have a sign up that we can pass around for decorating pumpkins. And then these pumpkins are really nice because you decorate them and they last really till like after Thanksgiving. And then you can also, if the pumpkin's still good, you can eat it for soup. So, and we'll just send that out. Okay. Yeah.
Morning, church. No, I know you see Pastor and some of you, or all of you here, see some of us in our Pathfinders uniform. But I want to remind you that we at Sterling, old and young, are all Pathfinders. And I would like to read the Pathfinders pledge so that the pastor could hear. All right, I would have had all of you do it, but I will do it for all of us this morning. We will be true, Pastor. We will be honest. We will be upright in our study, work, and play. And you can always count upon us to do our best. We will keep the Pathfinder's law. We ourselves will serve God first, last, and best in everything we do. Us are called upon to do our best, and we will do as we are called. Now, I sort of improvise. It's really I, but I put in we, so the pastor would know that I am referring to Sterling Pathfinders. Amen. I know you guys didn't put on your uniform this morning, but that's all right. The pastor would understand. So I want the pastor to know that we have, at Sterling, you have an army of pathfinders who are willing to serve in whatever capacity we are needed to. Behind you.
Thank you. Worship and giving. We live in a world today where people just like to get. But God says that when you give to Him, you're honoring Him. God's work needs resources. And today, I just want to invite you to share with the church the resources that God has given you. We are going to now collect our tithes and offerings, and the offerings and loose offerings would be for our local budget. Thank you, Lord, for these offerings and the tithes that have been presented. May they serve the purpose that they have been intended for, is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Children's story. It's now the time for Marie to give us the children's story.
Good morning, church. Hi, guys. And look at that. We got some new people coming. Nice. Keep filling them up. It's great. I say the same thing when I see the Portuguese church. I went, they have more people there than we do. So we need to fill it up. Tell everybody. But anyways, I had a lot of fun trying to figure out what to do for, oh boy, children's story. There's so much today on videos in the internet, and I didn't know what to do. But anyways, and I think this one would be cute. How many here like to cook? I'm going to tell Papa Joe right there, you got to take your little one, get her a hat, get her an apron, and watch the videos. They're adorable. And when I just couldn't help but laugh through the whole thing. It's only on for a few minutes. And the grandmother's trying to teach the little one how to cook and put the ingredients in. And every time he puts his hand right in it, and it's the funniest thing. She tries to stop him. So you got to look at the videos. They're adorable. So I was thinking, like, wow, what can I do today? And then I found a fall bucket list. I didn't even know they had one. Mm. And I went, well, I kind of like that. Because you can, what, make apple pie, pumpkin bread, right? Caramel apples. Oh, those are so good. And then s'mores on top of it. How many here like s'mores? Roasted marshmallows. Isn't that fun? Get out in a group and have a lot of fun. So that's one hat. Now, and then you got to have this one. This is for hiking. What do you think? Hayride? All outside stuff, right? Got to have fun, right? It's a time of year you can wear different hats. So I said, okay, we'll think about that. And you can rake leaves, jump in the leaves. I shared that guys with you guys a long time ago, not long ago, I think. We used to play hide and go seek with our dog. We didn't think he could find us in the leaves. He always did, every time. It was fun. And it's fun to do that. Of course, people like to watch football games and, you know, have bonfires, just have fun socializing. I said, well, what else can I do? So then I started thinking, well, all right. One more hat. This is Hat Day. You guys remember this one, right? Fawn loves this one. And you can be crafty. I did that. I had a lot of fun with that. I had it with the grandkids. And you can put the glitter on it while the paint's still wet. And then there's other things you can do. You know, make homemade applesauce. We did that with church ladies. I think Fawn was there. I'm not sure. A while back, we got together at somebody's house, and we had so much fun. I think it was Lorraine Lambert's house, the one that used to come here a long time ago. And how about decorating your house? Isn't that fun, too? And people decorate their porch. You know, it's kind of fun, right? All that kind of stuff. And then how about apple cider? Mmm. Well, you can have it warm or cold. And then when I've seen to a family fall gathering, they take the pumpkin, they gut it out, because I saw Fawn with that pumpkin there, and they'll put hot pumpkin soup in it or something. Different, huh? It's kind of fun being creative, isn't it? It's a time of year. And then I found something else that I thought was pretty cool, and I went, oh, the 7-Ups. Isn't that cute?
7-Ups.
So we're going to find out, and they got Bible verses. That even makes it more fun. And Joe, this is going to your family. It says, wake up. All right, everybody, stretch, right? Then it says, decide to have a good day. This is the day the Lord had made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Psalms 118:24. And we all got to what? Dress up, right? It says here, the best way to dress up is to put on a smile, right? Because who wants to see anybody who looks like this? No, right? So smile. Dress up with a smile. A smile is what? Inexpensive. It doesn't cost anything. It says to improve your looks. Okay? And it says here, the Lord does not look at the things man look at. Man looks at outward appearance, but God looks at the what? The heart. 1 Samuel 16:7. Then I was kind of surprised when I saw this on the bottom of the page. It says, shut up. I went, oh, let's find out what that is. Say nice things and learn to listen. Okay? It says, God gave us 2 ears and 1 mouth. So he must have meant for us, watch this, to do twice of what? Listening. Right? And what? Less? Okay. Less talking. He who guards his lip guards his soul. Proverbs 13:3. And then another thing we have to do, stand up for what is what? Right. Stand for something or you will fall for anything. We don't want to do that. It says, let us not be weary in doing good, for at the proper time, we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good. And that's in Galatians 9:10. And one thing my mom used to do a lot, look up, because who's up there? Our Lord, our God. Look up to the Lord. I can do everything through Christ who strengthens me. Philippians 4:13. I thought this is so cute. I found this on the internet. I was like, oh, this is adorable. I can share this. Then it has here, reach up for something what? Higher. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct what? Our path. Proverbs 3:5-6. Then we got to lift up our what? Our prayers. Do not worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Philippians 4:6. I went, wow, this is pretty cool. Now, positive thought, because we need to have positivity, don't we? There's a lot of negative right now, isn't there? It says, if God had a refrigerator, I thought this was cute, your picture would be on it. And if God had a wallet, your photo would be in it. He sends you flowers every spring and a sunrise every morning. So when you want to talk, he'll listen, right? And he could live anywhere in the universe, but he chose our what? Our heart. What about the Christmas gift he sent you in Bethlehem? Not to mention that Friday on Calvary. It says here, face it, he's crazy about you. Invite people here that you care about. I thought this was mighty special, just like you, pass this on and brighten someone's day. And guess what the last page is? It's adorable. God answers knee-mail. Not email, knee-mail. Get on our knees, right? So I have a cute song, and it's Twin Brothers, I believe, and I think you'll enjoy it. God bless.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm going to have to admit, I feel a little unusual up here. Since the COVID started, it's been very few times that I've sung anything here at church. The song that I'm going to try to sing this morning was one of my mother's favorite songs. She was my first accompanist when I was about 7 or 8 years old. And I have a tendency to sing songs that she liked. So, "Oh, Let Me Mark With Thee My God" is the name of this song. "Oh, let me walk with thee, my God, as Enoch walked in days of old. Place thou my trembling hand in thine, and sweet communion with me hold. Even though the path I may not see, yet Jesus, let me walk with thee. I cannot, dare not walk alone. The tempest rages in the sky. A thousand snares beset my feet. A thousand foes are lurking nigh. Still thou, the raging of the sea, O Master, let me walk with thee. If I may rest my hand in thine, I'll count the joys of earth but loss, and firmly, bravely journey on. A thousand foes are lurking nigh. Still thou, the raging of the sea, O Master, let me walk with thee.